In this how-to video, we'll cover the basics of configuring input types for the ProSense digital panel meters. I'm currently using a DPM3 meter, and we'll also set up a DPM2 and a DPM1 model in this same video. On the DPM3 meter, first I press the enter button and it displays PRO for program mode. I press right arrow button and the first selection is CNINP for control input. I press enter and can scroll through the input types. We want process control, so we press enter when we see PROC. We have two options, 20 milliamps or 10 volts. I select 20 milliamps and press enter, and we return to program mode. Now I press enter one more time and the panel stores my selections in memory. We're now set up with a 4 to 20 milliamp input in a DPM3 meter. Now let's configure the input for the DPM2 panel with a 4 to 20 milliamp input signal. I press the enter button and it displays program mode. Press enter again and it displays INP for inputs. Press enter again and you'll now see PROC for process control. And we can scroll through the various input types like temperature, potentiometers, and resistance. If we wanted to set up for temperature input, we select TNP for temperature, press enter, and we see options for thermocouple or RTD. We select PT1 for RTD and enter, and now the panel displays in Celsius with a tenths decimal place. We can use the right arrow button to scroll through selecting Fahrenheit or Celsius, and if we choose to use a decimal place. We press enter, and it allows us to select an offset. We choose 0, press enter, and it stores our setup. Now we get the error message OUE for over since we currently have a 4 to 20 milliamp input signal and not an RTD input. So let's set up for the correct input, 4 to 20 milliamps. I press the enter button and it displays program mode. Press enter again and it displays INP for inputs. Press enter again and you'll now see PROC for process control. And we press enter. And now we have amperage or voltage. We select A for amperage and press enter. The display returns to store. Now we're set up for a 4 to 20 milliamp input signal on our DPM2 model. Now let's configure a DPM1 model for amperage. The DPM1 models must be selected based on their input types, whereas the DPM2 and DPM3 typically offer multiple input types. This unit accepts amperage and voltage only. As you notice, the smaller DPM1 units do not have buttons on the face, but instead have them on the bottom of the panel. There are still three buttons, and they're still in the same configuration as the other two models. First, we press enter, and it displays PRO for program. I press enter again, and it quickly displays INP for input, and switches to A for amperage. I use the middle button to scroll through the input types until I get to the desired input type. We want amps, so I scroll until I see A. I press enter and we read DSP, then it quickly switches to SCAL for scale. I don't wish to scale in this setup, so I'll leave it at the default by pressing enter. INP1 for input 1 and 0.4.00 displays. We're using a 4 to 20 milliamp input, so we leave this one alone. Enter, and DSP1 displays with 0.4.00. Enter, and now we can adjust our decimal point. Enter, and INP2 displays 20.00. Enter, and DSP2 displays 20.00. Enter, and now the input type is stored into the unit. Now let's configure a DPM1T model for temperature. This one is connected to an RTD. First, press enter, and we see PRO for program. Press enter, and now we can scroll through the different temperature input types. I select P100 for this one because I have an RTD connected. Press enter, and we can select if we want to use a decimal point. Press Enter, and we can select Celsius or Fahrenheit. Then Enter, and we can choose an offset. I leave this one at 0, press Enter, and the value is now stored. This is how you set up the input types in the DPM1, DPM2, and DPM3 ProSense digital panel meters. Hope you found this video useful, and follow us to our other how-to videos on the ProSense digital panel meters. Thanks, and have a great day.